In this video, we're going to discuss and show the benefits of using the scheduler in Testim. But before we begin, we're going to make a few assumptions, namely that you've already created an account, you're able to log into Testim, and that you've gone ahead and created some steps. Also, we're going to be covering a number of different things in the context of this video. If there's something you don't understand or isn't clear, please go back to our website and check for a more appropriate video. So at this point, as you can see here, the first thing we want to do is get to where the scheduler is and test them. So if I click on runs here and scheduled runs, you can see here we've already got a couple of different scheduled tests that are scheduled to run. But before we get into the scheduler, it's probably important to level set and explain when or when you would not use the scheduler. So a good use case for using the scheduler would be a scenario where your team doesn't use any type of CI tool, so you're not using Jenkins or Bamboo or Azure DevOps, Circle CI, or those tools are prevalent at your company, however, your team doesn't have access to the team that's actually managing those tools. And you actually want, now that you've created some tests and test them, you want to actually schedule them to run and run on a specific schedule. So if we go ahead and click on Create New, this is where we can put in the name of our scheduled test. I could put in an example. And if we go over here, this is where I can pass in a different test that has labels associated with them, or I could pass in a test suite. So it's really helpful there. If I wanted to override the base URL, I could. If I wanted to run on a particular configuration, I could do that as well. And I would select that here. If I wanted to add a new configuration, this is where I could go in and do it. We can see these are all the different browser OS combinations that we support, different resolutions as well. So that could be really helpful if you need to test different types of resolutions. And then here's all the major browsers, of course. So let's go ahead and cancel that. On the right-hand side, if we wanted to run it on a particular schedule, I could select the days where I want to run it. So at this point, it would run Wednesday through Sunday. I want it to run every day of the week, I can check that. And at this point, it's going to default, it's going to run at midnight in GMT time on every single day of the week, but I could adjust the time if I wanted to do that in here as well. If we scroll down here, we can decide where we want these tests to run. Of course, right now, they're going to run on the Testim grid, but if I had, or if I was using another Selenium cloud provider, I could choose to run these tests and tests on a different infrastructure if I wanted to do that. And then down here at the bottom, on every failure, we're going to, so I could pick every failure, every first failure. So it's really flexible in how you want to configure this. Notify us if there's a failure. And then here I can select Slack. I have it sending me an email, but I could also have it send a Slack message to a particular Slack channel. So if I click that, I could say I want it to send to this channel, or I could have it actually send a webhook, and I can pass in the URL for the webhook if I wanted to do that. A lot of teams that use this, obviously Slack is a very common integration. So if we click over here, we can see tests that have failed, and we're posting the failures to Slack. So if I click on one of these tests, it's going to bring me up to the actual failed test and test them, at which point I can actually tag this particular failed test, or I could create an issue in Jira or another ticketing tool if I was using that. So if we go back to scheduled runs and click on create new, the other option here is, you know, maybe you're working with a team and you need to monitor a responsive web application. We also have a monitoring schedule. So I could schedule a set of tests to run every 5 minutes, every 10 minutes. And then, of course, I can decide, again, where I want to run these tests as well. So hopefully this gave you some insight into how to use the scheduler with Testim. Hopefully this information was helpful. Feel free to go out to our website or reach out to us if you have additional information.